With no one very senior and therefore got hold of Sadhvi Pragya Thakur from this constituency.
You know, because at the end of the day, therefore, Amit Malviya, what is the... I came back to the question which I started off. What is the message you're sending out? The Prime Minister talks loftily of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, and then goes to Nagpur and says, no Hindu can ever be a terrorist, which is completely flying in the face of facts as they exist. The fact is, terrorism has been committed in this country by different groups. Yes, there are Muslims who've been involved, and a large number of them. Yes, there have been Hindus who have been involved. Is the Prime Minister, is this government somehow, by putting up a Sadhvi Pragya, doing what Yogendra Yadav is accusing EU of, trying to once again take the agenda from the real issues of jobs? A new report says 50 lakh jobs were lost after demonetization, agrarian distress, which Madhya Pradesh has been hit by. Take away from those issues, allow the media, channels like me, and programs like this to focus on Sadhvi Pragya. Is that the agenda? To change the headline? This is headline management once again with an aim to polarize. That's the charge made by Yogendra Yadav.
You know, Rajdeep, I heard Yogendra Yadav give a very sanctimonious lecture on polarizing. Mm-hmm. I remember in April 2014 when he was the candidate from Gurgaon for Aam Aadmi Party, from which he has now been ousted. There was a story that started doing the round saying Yogendra Yadav is also known as Salim. It was something that just came as part of the narrative when he was contesting this election, and presumably because there are some pockets of Muslim population in Gurgaon. So, you know, I don't want lectures from Yogendra Yadav on polarization. I don't want lectures from him on Hindu-Muslim, because the whole country has seen this story that erupted surreptitiously in April of 2014.
Answer my direct question.
I'm coming to your question, Rajdeep. I'm coming to your question.
Yeah, I will let you respond. Let him first finish.
No, let me finish. You know, because since you quoted Yogendra Yadav twice, yes, I thought I must fix the narrative and actually bring out the other side of the sanctimonious lecture that we get from him usually on television programs. Mm-hmm. The other issue is about the kind of terror that we see. World over, it is known that there is Islamic Jihad that is being unleashed on people across the world. The ISIS, Boko Haram, LET, and all kinds of organizations are a manifestation of it. If you or Yogendra Yadav think that there's nothing called Islamic terror, then clearly you are free to delude yourself.
I have not said that. Please do not put words in my mouth, Amit Malviya. I'm asking you a straight question again, to which I want a straight answer. Malegaon happens, Ajmer Sharif happens, the Mecca Masjid blast happens, and suddenly, mysteriously, all those who are accused, linked to Hindutva groups, are being exonerated, and now not only exonerated, but are contesting elections. I ask you again, Mr. Malviya.
Question, but you should be patient enough to listen to what I'm saying. You did not speak about Samjhauta blast. Mm-hmm. Why was Colonel Purohit indicted in that blast when the United Nations in 2007 and the United States state report very clearly said that it was the LET and wings of it which were involved in the blast? Why did the UPA ignore what the United Nations Security Council said? They named a guy called Arif. Why did the UPA ignore what the United States Security Department put out? I want to ask you this question. Why were Hindus targeted? Why did Asimanand get away despite the Congress?
Asimanand has been caught. I don't want to go into the details, but Asimanand has been caught on a sting operation admitting to his role. I am asking you the bigger question. I am asking you the bigger question, sir. Is this an attempt made to polarize the voters? Country?
Sir, I asked you about the United States Security Council and the United States.
I am asking you a simpler question, the political question, sir. I am asking you the political question. What's the message you're trying to send out? The Prime Minister speaks of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, and speaks of nationalism, and you have put in place, at the moment, she's still a terror accused. I will keep saying that till she's acquitted. She is a terror accused. The BJP has put up in the prestigious constituency of Bhopal, Mr. Malviya, a terror accused, only to make a polarizing political point. Am I right or wrong?
Rajdeep, you can call her what you like. The reality is that Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas also includes Hindus of this country.
Of course it does.
Who cannot be left to fend for themselves.
Of course it does.
Left to you, you would want Hindus to be second-rate citizens in this country.
On what basis are you saying that?
What do you mean that Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas does not mean that somebody like Sadhvi Pragya Thakur should get justice? What do you mean by saying sabka saath, sabka vikas? Do you think she does not have the right to dignity?
Of course she has, but she has not been acquitted, sir.
Who's going to give it back to her?
Mr. Malviya, she's not been acquitted.
Who's going to give Sadhvi Pragya Thakur 10 years back to her?
Okay.
You answer that question.
Okay, Yogendra Yadav.
Who's going to give her 10 years back?
Okay, Yogendra Yadav.
Who's going to give her her health back?
Okay.
Who is going to give her mental peace back? Okay. Tell me that thing.
Okay. Let Yogendra Yadav now respond. Yogendra Yadav, you've been accused also of polarizing during the 2014 election. Direct charge made by Amit Malviya. And he claims that Sadhvi Pragya Thakur is someone who today is a symbol of the system trying to victimize Hindus as terrorists, particularly the previous UPA government.
Rajdeep, somehow Mr. Amit Malviya thinks that by raising all those questions about 2014, he would get me off the track and not remind of the basic things. Number one, no one on this show has so far contradicted the fact that Pragya Thakur ji is a terror accused right now under trial, not convicted, not exonerated. And for any party to put up a terror accused is a serious violation of maryada of the minimum kind. Of course, it's legally possible, but it is ethically unacceptable. It is politically unacceptable. He has also not denied the fact that Chief Minister of Haryana, Mr. Khattar, has publicly said that he is asking for support from DERA, from the chief who is not just accused, who is a murder and rape convict. Now, 2014, the story did not somehow erupt, Mr. Malviya. BJP held a press conference and accused me. That is how it came in the press. BJP accused me that my original name is Salim, that I'm using it for election purpose. I had said then, please show me one clipping, please show me one record, and I would not only withdraw from elections, I would withdraw from public life forever. And for your record, Mr. Malviya, the fact is that my grandfather, I don't know how much of you have suffered from communal conflict, my dadaji, my grandfather Ram Singh ji, was murdered by a Muslim mob in the presence of my father. But those were the days of Mahatma Gandhi. It changed my father's. He could have become one of persons like you. He could have become someone who shouts like you in the name of Hindus, Hindus, Hindus. He was a disciple of Gandhi. It transformed his heart. And he decided to give every one of his children a Muslim name. Now, I do not think it is possible for someone like appreciate. In any other country, someone would have written novels about it. Someone who saw his father being killed. Gandase se uska sar kaat diya tha mere dadaji ka. And that child who saw his father being murdered actually decides to name his children after the name of persons from the community who murdered him. This is who I am. I do not take any credit for that. Credit must be given to my father, who is 90 plus now. But this is the story, Mr. Malviya. I do not know if people like you are capable of understanding human sensitivity of this kind. I still challenge you, produce one record, one video, one audio of my using it for election purpose. I will withdraw from public life forever. Otherwise, please shut up.
Very, very strong.
You have been shunted from public life. Forget about withdrawal.
No, no, no. Let's not make this personal.
Mind your language.
No.
You can't ask
me
to shut up.
Mr. Malviya.
You bloody well shut up.
Mr. Malviya.
And mind your language.
Mr. Malviya. I gave you equal time.
You can't allow for such language.
He says you have passed out a fake story. He's making his point.
You have been shunted out of public life.
Okay.
You are a nobody in public life.
That's your view.
That's your view, Mr. Malviya.
So that's your view, Mr. Malviya.
Don't tell
Mr.
me what
Malviya,
I have to do.
There is nobody. There is
Rajdeep,
no need. There is
you
no
can't
need to make
allow
it personal.
Such language on your program.
He has
You can't allow such language on your program.
What has he said?
Can't allow this language on
what
your program.
What has he said, Mr. Malviya? What has he said that has offended you? He has said you are passing out fake
news. Well, I just told him exactly what he asked me to do, to shut up.
Okay. Both of you have asked each other to shut up. The fact is, this country is watching. Let this country decide where it stands on an issue of a terror accused who has been put up in a constituency called Bhopal.